In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, one God. Amen. Today's story will be about Saint Abanoub. Saint Abanoub was born in a city named Nihisa. He was born to Christian parents named Makar and Maryam. Abanoub's parents taught him to love God with all his heart. When Abanoub turned 12 years old, his parents passed away. Saint Abanoub always attended church and respected church and did not talk in a church during prayer. One day, Abanoub heard Abuna giving a sermon and saying, "The king Diocletianus is persecuting the Christians and closing the churches. Don't worry. Our Lord Jesus Christ said to us, 'Be of good cheer. It is I. Do not be afraid.' Don't forget that our goal is to live in heaven eternally with Jesus." After hearing this sermon, Saint Abanoub decided to confess his faith in Jesus Christ to the king and give all his money to the poor. Saint Abanoub went to the governor of Samannout and told him, "I am Christian and my Lord is Jesus Christ." The king said to him, "You are young and I don't want to punish you." Saint Abanoub answered him bravely and said, "The idols that you worship are made of stone and can't even hear, talk, or feel. But my Lord Jesus Christ is alive and mighty." The king got angry with what Abanoub was saying and said, "Throw Abanoub in jail." While Abanoub was in jail, he kneeled and praised God. The people in the jail said, "Who is this cat? And what is he doing here?" Abanoub answered them and said, "The king put me in here because I refused to bow down and worship the idols. I encourage every one of you to join me in prayer to God because he loves us all." Then they all started to say together, "Have mercy, have mercy, have mercy upon us, O God, our Savior. Lord, have mercy." The king became frustrated with Abanoub and decided to take him to the governor of Atrip to find a solution with him. They journeyed on a boat and the king said, "Tie and hang him upside down and let's see what his God is going to do about it." Immediately after, Saint Abanoub prayed to God and said, "My Lord, my Lord, my Lord." Suddenly, Archangel Michael came down from heaven and untied Saint Abanoub. At that moment, the king became paralyzed and his soldiers were blinded. The king said to Abanoub, "If your God heals us, I will be Christian." Abanoub answered him and said, "God will heal you after you confess your faith to the king of Atrip." When they arrived at the king of Atrip, the governor of Samannout and his soldiers surely confessed their faith. The king of Atrip looked at them and said, "Are you all crazy? What are you saying?" Saint Abanoub told him, "Jesus Christ is the true God." Soon after, the king of Atrip, gave an order to put Abanoop next to the fire to see if Jesus will help him or not. Saint Abanoop had remembered what he learned in church about making the sign of the cross whenever he feels scared or in trouble. He started to making the sign of the cross and say, "In the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, one God, Amen." Suddenly, Jesus appeared to him, along with Archangel Michael and Gabriel. Jesus spoke to him, saying,
"Don't be afraid, Abanoop. The fire will not hurt you, and you will soon come to me in heaven."
Abanoop cheered and said, "Look, it's Jesus. I love you, Jesus. Glory be to you, O Lord." Shortly after, Abanoop was taken to the governor of Alexandria. There, the king ordered to put him in a room full of snakes. Saint Abanoop held up the cross and prayed that Jesus might help him. And Jesus surely saved him from the snakes. After a journey of hardships, Abanoop went to heaven and received 3 heavenly crowns. Today, there is a church by his name in Samannut, where his body is also there. What we can learn from the story of Saint Abanoop? We should learn to love God, respect the church, and not be afraid, because Jesus promises to be with us all the times and save us. May the holy blessing of Saint Abanoop with us all. Amen. Pray for me and see you next time. Bye.